nomenclature of the amines. That is the IUPAC nomenclature of amines. Now see here. So first we will see the example. Here methyl group, that is the ester. Last time we have seen that what are the primary amines, secondary amines and the tertiary amines. So that is a CH3NH2. So here one hydrogen atom replaced by the methyl. So that is a common name. That is first we have to write the alkyl name and followed by the amine. So methyl group attached to the nitrogen, so it is called the methyl amine. But in the IUPAC nomenclature, we have to see that first we have to write the name of the alkane and that E from alkane replaced by the amine word. So that is name becomes the methane amine. Now see the second CH3CH2CH3. Or we can collectively write C2H5NH2. So that ethyl group is attached. So the name of the compound, common name becomes ethyl amine. Here the alkane, that is the ethane, so E replaced by the amine. Third, that is the two methyl groups, so 1 and 2 attached to the nitrogen atom. So both alkyl groups are same, so the name becomes dimethyl amine. But in the IUPAC name, we have to take one alkyl group as a parent alkane. Now see that here. So first one methyl group attached to the amine group and another as a substitute. So this methyl group attached to the nitrogen. So we have to prefix use, that is N methyl methane amine. So in the next, that is a two alkyl groups are different. Now here, so in the common name, two alkyl groups, the first name that is starts from E, the second alkyl group starts from the N. So alphabetically in order, so ethyl, then methyl, so last that is a amine. So ethyl, methyl, amine. But in IUPAC name, so here one carbon atom is there, here two carbon. So longest chain will becomes of the ethyl group. So that methyl group now become the substituted group. So N methyl, now nomenclature becomes N methyl ethanamine. Next, that is a both are same. So here also ethyl group is there, another also ethyl group is there. So the common name becomes diethyl amine. Previously seen that is a dimethyl amine. Similarly, diethyl amine. Now here, both are same, one group as a parent alkane. So the ethyl group attached to the nitrogen. So it becomes N ethyl ethanamine. Next, there is a tertiary amine there. So three methyl group attached to the nitrogen. So three for that, trimethyl amine. But now, for the IUPAC group, one alkyl group as a parent and another two alkyl groups becomes now substituted group. So this methyl also attached to the nitrogen, another methyl also attached to the nitrogen. So prefix becomes N-N-dimethyl-methanamine. That N-N show that first methyl group also attached to the nitrogen and another group also attached to the nitrogen. Now next, there are two alkyl groups are same, one is a different. So here, so first that is the ethyl, two are the methyl groups, so we can write as the ethyl dimethyl amine. For IUPAC name, that ethyl group used as a parent alkane, so name becomes N-N dimethyl ethanamine. So long chain for the ethane. Next, that your two ethyl groups are there and one methyl group is there. So here, that is C2H5. So two ethyl groups are there, so diethyl. One methyl group is there, so diethyl methyl amine. But in IUPAC name, one ethyl group used as a parent alkane. So that is, so N-ethyl ethanamine. So the nomenclature becomes that is N-ethyl ethanamine. Now next, that is a aromatic amine is there. So benzene group attached to sorry, that is a phenyl group attached to the aniline NH2. So the common name became the aniline. So benzene group attached to the amine, so that is called the benzamine. Similarly, here nitro group attached to the aniline. So that is the position 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4, that is a para position. So P nitro aniline. And in the IUPAC name, we have to write the number. So that becomes the 4 nitro aniline. So that is the IUPAC nomenclature for the amines. So thank you very much.